Harvard researchers observe a state of matter predicted and hunted for 50 years, but never previously observed. In 1973, physicist Philip W. Anderson theorized the existence of a new state of matter that has been a major focus of the field, especially in the race for quantum computers. This bizarre state of matter is called a quantum spin liquid, and contrary to the name, has nothing to do with everyday liquids like water. Instead, it is all about magnets that never freeze and the way electrons in them spin. In regular magnets, when the temperature drops below a certain temperature, the electrons stabilize and form a solid piece of matter with magnetic properties. In quantum spin liquid, the electrons don't stabilize when cooled, don't form into a solid, and are constantly changing and fluctuating, like a liquid, in one of the most entangled quantum states ever conceived. The different properties of quantum spin liquids have promising applications that can be used to advance quantum technologies such as high-temperature superconductors and quantum computers. But the problem about this state of matter has been its very existence. No one had ever seen it. At least that had been the case for almost 50 years. A team of Harvard-led physicists said they have finally experimentally documented this long-sought-after exotic state of matter. The work is described in a new study in the journal Science and marks a big step toward being able to produce this elusive state on demand and to gain a novel understanding of its mysterious nature. The learnings from this science research could one day provide advancements for designing better quantum materials and technology. More specifically, the exotic properties from quantum spin liquids could hold the key to creating more robust quantum bits known as topological qubits that are expected to be resistant to noise and external interference. The research teams set out to observe this liquid-like state of matter using programmable quantum simulator the lab originally developed in 2017. The simulator is a special kind of quantum computer that allows the researchers to create programmable shapes like squares, honeycombs, or triangular lattices to engineer different interactions and entanglements between ultra-cooled atoms. It is used to study a host of complex quantum processes. The idea of using the quantum simulator is to be able to reproduce the same microscopic physics found in condensed matter systems, especially with the freedom that the programmability of the system allows. In conventional magnets, electron spins point up or down in some regular pattern. In the everyday refrigerator magnet, for example, the spins all point toward the same direction. This happens because the spins usually work in a checkerbox pattern and can pair so that they can point in the same direction or alternating ones, keeping a set in order. Quantum spin liquids display none of that magnetic order. This happens because essentially there is a third spin added, turning the checkerbox pattern to a triangular pattern. While a pair can always stabilize in one direction or another, in a triangle, the third spin will always be the odd electron out. This makes for a frustrated magnet where the electron spins can't stabilize in a single direction. The Harvard scientists used the simulator to create their own frustrated lattice pattern, placing the atoms there to interact and entangle. The researchers were then able to measure and analyze the strings that connected the atoms after the whole structure entangled. The presence and analysis of those strings, which are called topological strings, signified that quantum correlations were happening and that the quantum spin liquid state of matter had emerged. After confirming the presence of quantum spin liquids, the researchers turned to the possible application of this state of matter to creating the robust qubits. They performed a proof-of-concept test that showed it may one day be possible to create these quantum bits by putting the quantum spin liquids in a special geometrical array using the simulator. The researchers plan to use the programmable quantum simulator to continue to investigate quantum spin liquids and how they can be used to create the more robust qubits. Qubits, after all, are the fundamental building blocks on which quantum computers run and the source of their massive processing power.